Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. In today's video, guys, we're working here on Mercedes, guys, and we'll show you guys how to remove and replace springs on front struts. And this one will relate not just to Mercedes, many vehicles will be that way, guys. Most of the newer vehicles will be about the same procedure with some minor differences, of course. So we have a new strut here, that's our old strut, and the new one does not come with the spring. Okay, you can see it doesn't come with anything else, so we need to swap all that stuff. Stay with us, you can find the tools, guys, and parts that we use in the description of the video, so let's start on it now. Okay guys, so we need to take the tool. Okay, that's a spring compressor tool. We need to, okay, you adjust it like that and you lock it in place. Okay, the two pins have to be locked in place, and you have to be very, very careful, okay, using that tool. Okay guys, so that could be very, very dangerous job. One thing that you should never ever do, never ever stay in front of the strut or on the backside. This is because if something goes wrong, that spring is going to shoot out of there with enormous force that can kill you guys. So if you don't feel comfortable, don't do it, okay? Go to a place that they know what they're doing. And usually with that too, it's pretty safe, but again, there is always risk involved with that. So we are installing the second one now. Okay. Gotta make sure that you just get it right. So we can install the locking pin as well. Okay guys, so we are going to get a socket that fits our tool now. Okay, and we'll get tight on one side and then on the other one. Okay, this side is good. Now we need to go to the next side. You can do one on this side, one on the other, so not just to go always sudden on one side. And we have that rubber in the way, that's not helping us a lot. Okay, we'll go a little bit on the other side now. Okay, towards the end it will be really hard, so we won't even be able to use the little impact, so we have to use the ratchet. Okay, it's getting loose. Now we're going to switch to the other side. Okay, and do a little bit here now. And I'll show you when we need to stop. Okay, so you gotta make sure that it's loose, guys. Okay, you can see we don't have any tension on the spring now. That's very important. So next step, with the socket, there is one nut on front of the strut. Okay, that you need to remove. Usually, okay, stay out of the way, because if you have any tension on the spring, that thing can kill you. Okay, the nut is out. Okay, so now it's important, guys, to be very, very careful again. Okay, right there, you can see the spring is stuck in the rubber a little bit. Okay, perfect. Now what we need to do, okay, that we need to unhook, okay, the rubber there, because it gets stuck, so it cannot pull up and dust doesn't go in the shock, so that's why it's invented that way. Next we can just go ahead, okay, pull it out. It's holding a little bit our thing there. Okay, and eventually, okay, it gets loose, guys. Okay, and it comes out of there. Okay, you can see this is the spring assembly, this is the strut. Next you need to transfer everything on the new strut. So we start with that bottom piece of rubber that the spring lays on. Otherwise, if you don't install this one, you're going to hear a lot of noise from your suspension. Okay, after that, this is the absorber right there. So we're going to install this one now. Okay, perfect. You have to try to pull the strut as much as you can, because sometimes they might be in a little bit. Okay, perfect. Next, okay, you have to install, okay, the spring where it used to lay there. Okay, don't stay on top of the strut, always from the side, guys, always from the side. Okay, you can see we got it in place now. And next thing, we'll have to install the nut there. Okay guys, so we installed everything in reverse order, we took it apart. Next thing, don't stay in the way, we're going to install the nut on top. Okay, catch the nut, we need to get that nut tight now. Okay, and once we get it out, we'll proceed with the next step. Alright guys, every model will have different torque specs. You can check them with the torque wrench because the sport and the other models will be different. Okay guys, so we are going to get both of them loose now, one at a time, a little bit on each side, okay? Probably about 4-5 revolutions on one side, 4-5 on the other one. Okay, this one is pretty tight. Never stay in front or behind it. Okay, we are towards the end on both sides. You see, we got them loose, a little bit on each side, then you alternate. You go to the other side, back and forth like that. Now we have to pull the safety pins out. We did scratch our spring, as you can see, but it's really hard to do on the one with the sport suspension, guys, because it's a very short strut. Okay, this one is stuck a little bit there. Okay, came out now, and the bottom pin as well there. You have to help them sometimes, because if it's a bigger spring, they tend to get stuck a little bit. Okay, this one came loose as well. Now it's time to get it out. Okay, you can see, just like that, guys. You gotta make sure that everything is put together right. You can check your nut again. Okay, make sure that this nut on top is very tight. And this will be the whole procedure. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe and see you next time.